Good morning. So you join me at this ungodly early hour of the morning of 7 a.m. as I've got the canal closed for me, specially to drive a rather large boat for a very small tunnel. So it looks like here's something up ahead that'll give you a hint to where we are. And here's the canal. And if I'm right, just over there is where we'll shortly be going. So I'm just going to wander down here to show you something. So in the 1980s, the tunnel was deemed too dangerous in the centre to be used anymore, and it needed to be dug out and replaced, which it was replaced with these concrete rings that you see on the right hand side here. Now I believe that's a similar construction method to the Channel Tunnel. Anyway, let's carry on and go find my boat. And there she is. In case you haven't guessed, we are here in Stoke Bruin. So here we go. You may be able to see that gentleman walk up the towpath there. He's the guy that's going to see us through the tunnel. So bye bye, Stoke Bruin. So we're now approaching the entrance to the tunnel, but we've got to just pull over on the right hand side first. So now I'm making the final part of the journey back towards the car. Now, as you can see just here, that is one of the ventilation shafts that was dug during the construction of the tunnel. And as you recall probably from the video where we're going through, the water coming from the ceiling, that's probably come from there, because there was a big hole all the way up and you can see daylight. Now, there's several of these and the landscape's quite hilly, as you can probably see over there. And probably a lot of that is the spoil heaps from when they built the tunnel. So as I walk back towards where my car is, you can sort of see there's quite a big mound here. And if I can get a better view through a gap here, you can just about see in the distance there's another one of the ventilation shafts. I'm now nearly back at my car, so I'm going to say goodbye and I'll see you all very soon. Bye-bye!